Hey everyone, welcome to Tomorrow Biostasis YouTube channel. Today we're going to review 12 facts that you probably didn't know about cryonics. Fact number one, the bodies are stored upside down. The bodies are indeed stored upside down inside the doors. Like this, the liquid that we use to cool down the bodies, liquid nitrogen, in case of an emergency and the liquid boils off uncontrollably, the head is the last thing to get in contact with room temperature. Fact number two, the doors actually don't work like a regular freezer, they more work like a thermos. This is because the liquid nitrogen stored inside the door is isolated from the outside with a vacuum.
Fact number three, the father of cryonics, Robert Ettinger, has only been cryopreserved for 10 years. He's considered the father of cryonics because he wrote the book, The Prospect of Immortality, all the way back in 1962, which laid the foundation for the cryonics movement and outlined concepts such as vitrification, which is used by all cryopreservation organizations today. And he lived to the long age of 92. In 2011, he passed away and was successfully cryopreserved at Cryonics Institute. Fact number four, cryopreserving someone before they are legally dead is considered homicide. The reason is because today, revival isn't possible. So if you took someone that was alive and cryopreserved them, by today's standards, you would technically be killing them. So it's not allowed. You have to wait until they're legally declared dead to start the procedure.
Fact number five, storing a cryopreserved patient doesn't require electricity. The liquid we use to store the patient is liquid nitrogen. Liquid nitrogen is at a liquid state, minus 196 degrees. And this is more than enough to store the patient and doesn't require any electricity.
Fact number six, when you are being cryopreserved, you're technically donating your body to research, which is what makes it legally possible in most countries. When you sign up for cryopreservation, you sign a biostasis contract, which includes the body donation clause. And this is what allows it to be legally possible because, of course, most countries don't specifically have laws around cryopreservation, but they will allow you to donate your body to research. In this case, the research is keeping you cryopreserved and reviving you in the future. Fact number seven, some cryonics organizations allow the family members of patients to have a kind of funeral ceremony. For example, Yinfeng in China allows the families to be a part of some of the procedures to witness the cool down and also have a kind of funeral ceremony after they are in the door. Fact number eight, pets can also be cryopreserved. In fact, today there are about 250 animals in cryopreservation. Of course, to have your pet cryopreserved, you also need to be signed up yourself because we wouldn't want your furry friend to be waking up in the future alone.
Fact number nine, a study was done on nematodes called C. elegans and their olfactory imprinting was studied, since it's a form of long-term memory. And it was found out that mechanism which regulates odorant imprinting was preserved in these C. elegans after cryopreservation and revival. Fact number 10, patients are not directly placed into a door with liquid nitrogen. After legal pronouncement, they go through a series of medical and surgical procedures and then a gradual cooling down over days before they are moved into a door. So fact number 11, a study was published showing the case history of rabbit kidneys that survived vitrification and subsequent transplantation. And it showed us that it is completely feasible to do complex system vitrification, but they still have obstacles that we still need to overcome.
Fact number 12, the average Tomorrow Biostasis member is 36 years old. This might be surprising to some people because you would think, you know, cryopreservation is something that happens after you die, so probably a lot of older people are signing up. But that actually is not the case. And there's good reason for that. So first of all, if you sign up younger, you get significantly better rates on term life insurance. It is possible, of course, to pay for your cryopreservation when you're older, but if you only think about setting up financing when you're already older, it's significantly harder to do. So it makes sense usually to figure this out a little earlier in life and also secure yourself against risk. In addition to that, perhaps people that are a bit younger are a little bit more open-minded, a little bit more understanding of technology and the trends, so this is probably why the age is younger than you might expect.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you tomorrow.